and welcome everyone to the last episode of the main season of season four. That's pretty crazy. Week 15, episode four. We're finally here. Playoffs is coming right around the corner. I'm excited, and I hope you guys are too. But today I have with me Gummeljack.
I hope you're ready.
If you missed the Uchiha match, let me just fill you in real quick. Burn had a migraine, so he is taking a break from commentating. He's still here with us, but you won't be able to hear him.
He's in spirit.
Yes, he's here in spirit with us. So, yeah.
Burn, how could you say that?
How could you say that, Burn? God damn it. But yeah. Anyway, so our matches today are going to be Team Jinchuuriki at Team Guy and The Akatsuki at Hidden Sand. Interesting stuff. Now, none of these matches actually will mean anything.
Doesn't the Akatsuki one create some sort of issue, though, with that, depending on who wins?
Yeah,
if Akatsuki takes the win, Akatsuki then wins. It becomes a four-way tie?
Yeah, I believe so. Four-way tie, or is it? Something like that. Four-way tie. Yeah. But that is against Sand. Akatsuki at Sand. And Sand has been knocked out of playoffs. So, yeah. Because Taka won, Sand's out. So, yeah. I mean, it's kind of important if Akatsuki wins or not. Because it creates an issue. Well, not really an issue, but it becomes a pain in the butt to decide who ends up where. But
yeah.
Yeah.
As for the Jin versus a Guy match, is Guy fighting for anything? Or are they in playoffs or nothing?
Sage is out of playoffs. So
okay. Guy, so they. Yeah. Okay. So this match here is mainly just for win-loss record, pretty much.
Yeah. They want to show us up because, you know, Guy and Jinchuuriki have a little bit of a beef. So. Yes, it's a rematch.
Yeah, except they took PTS Scar from us.
Yeah, and they're using him against us, which good call, Anthony. That's a very good call. Anyway, let's not delay this anymore and get right into Jinchuuriki at Guy. Right. Round number one, we have 10-10 with single PTS Gaara versus Naruto, Kushina, and Fu.
Naruto's starting off just how he likes it with his tilt, and wow!
Oh, commit!
that connected, actually. That actually has some good range to it.
Yeah.
Didn't do much damage, though. Naruto's built like a tank.
Yeah. Kushina trying to do some damage here.
Now, did Guy have any money in the boost to use for this match?
I don't think they had any money in the bank, but let me check. They had 3k, and I don't think they used any of it.
Okay. Just curious, but I know Jin used their last little bit to, what was it, to get a few boosts for this match?
Yeah, we had 7k, so we used it. On an attack plus one for Kushina, because she had defense plus two on her. And then we used ultimate tilt on Fu.
Okay, yeah. Had to use it or you're gonna lose it, you know. Don't want to go to waste.
Yeah,
full combo from Kushina.
Into another strike back.
Into the air.
Wow. And sand shower. Naruto kind of stood there for a moment.
He's feeling the fire. He's just like, yes.
I'm already on fire.
This burns my QB skin.
QB skin. And Tenten throwing out all of her shuriken. Fan slash will connect. And I did, I don't even think I told you about this, Gomo, but that is why I wanted to have two range supports. Oh, ultimate again. She's going to tank this, though. Is why I wanted to have two range supports in our first lineup because I thought that they would start.
Okay.
So yeah.
Makes sense. I mean, she doesn't really have any range herself, but yeah. Naruto. Oh, frying pan. So this is kind of like, who's the real master of weapons here?
Right.
I think Ushin in mind, you know, she's got frying pans, pots. I mean, what does Tenten have?
Ladle. Like,
I mean, like bombs and kunai.
Yeah, that's what? Pussy shit.
Yeah, come on. This is how ninjas started. I mean, you know, the true battle's in the kitchen, right, Ushin?
Yeah. She knows. Oh! Pots and pans.
Damn,
son.
They're hot. They're burning.
Full combo.
Wow.
And Naruto.
Combo from Boo tags out. Notice they've actually been equally, like, Naruto's been in fairly often. Same with Boo and Kushina. Chain the combo though. They had subs too. They weren't even subs.
Yeah. Kushina is kind of the centerpiece of our team this week though. She is in three times.
Yeah, she's the theme.
Yeah, pretty much. Ultimate, no.
Oh, so she was gonna ran to that.
And of course, you know,
yeah.
The centerpiece of Guy's team is PTS Gaara. They have used him three times.
And speaking of PTS Gaara, I was gonna say, he hasn't really been in.
He's
been tagging out Tenten.
It's a trend I've noticed with this Tenten and Gaara team, and I believe I said this in an endcast a few weeks ago. I don't know if it's a good team for PTS Gaara, because it's mainly Tenten. So yeah, he hasn't done much, but he does a lot when it's not him and Tenten.
Oh, that was actually nice. You see that?
They
strike backed and Naruto used Rasengan, it missed, but that was good.
Tenten is on low health. Yeah. No ointments.
She threw ointments, didn't she?
Yeah.
Build from Naruto. Oh!
Team ult.
Ultimate.
Going to connect and get rid of that green bar.
Good damage.
Yeah.
And it's gonna knock him out of the range of even getting, if they use a limit, they're not gonna get enough to get their green bar back.
Yeah, we don't have a green bar anymore. That's okay. Maybe Fu will be able to finish it here.
What? He, like, they team ulted, stopped the team ult, and then went to normal ult?
Man, Fu really wanted to finish that.
He wanted to finish it with style,
That's how Fu gets it done.
Yes, she does, yeah, that's how she gets it done. Squashing Tenten like a little bug.
So a little bit of a comeback there from Team Guy, but not enough to secure two handicaps for them, unfortunately.
Unfortunately. They did take a handicap, though, at least, so that'll at least help them going into the next lineup.
Yep, we'll see you in the next round.
All right, on to round two. We have Lee and Gaara, PTS Gaara, versus the same lineup as last time. Naruto, Fu, and Kushina. So they just take one handicap out of their favor, so Guy's looking to either green bar this or at least take it with a handicap, just to kind of even it out slightly, but ideally they're looking for no handicaps.
Yeah, but so far, Jinchuuriki has done the brunt of the damage. Ultimate from Lee will connect
with
the food pill on top. Nice.
Good damage there.
Sand shower will connect, but Naruto subs it, tried to tilt there.
I've noticed this Naruto has had a difficult time with Lenny's ultimates. Like, he uses them like crazy, and they just dodge.
Yeah, it seems like Biju mode Naruto actually landed his way more. Ultimate from Lee will not reach, and a tilt!
I guess Naruto's fed up with it, he's just tilting out. Alright.
Yeah.
Tilt! So he's gonna tilt.
He's gonna tilt. And yeah, so far a lot of damage done by Team Guy here.
Typically Lee, I don't know if Gaara's been doing much once again, just because it feels like even Lee likes to hang out a lot.
Oh yeah, for sure. But yeah, a lot of damage really starting to bring it back here. Full combo.
Yeah, they had no subs either, so I mean.
Oh, this is gonna get canceled.
Yeah.
Yep.
Another team ultimate.
Will not connect.
Pretty good usually. They dodging those team ults is sometimes.
Yeah.
They usually hit by the third one a lot of times.
Ooh.
Wow, they nice.
And Naruto charging up his chakra really quickly with that charge assist. Team ult going to connect.
Wow, I don't think this is going to Gaara's built tanky, right?
Let's check actually. No. He's built for ultimates.
He might actually
still there. Flashing chakra dash is there.
Kind of backing away a little bit.
Yeah. Frying pan attack.
Guard slings his body into the attack.
Yeah. Oh, there's an ultimate.
Oh, wow.
So barely hanging on to their green bar there.
Yeah, that's, I mean, that's what they needed.
Yeah, not bad at all. All right, so we will move into the next round with no handicaps. All right, and on to round three, we have the same team again from Team Guy versus now Tobirama and Kushina.
Yeah, even round, so we'll see what happens here.
Yeah, no handicaps. Since they did green bar last time. And that tilt from Lee.
Since Kushina's very melee heavy, just like Lee is, it might not be bad for her specifically because she is built a little more defensively, and I think Lee is built offensively, am I correct?
Yes, an attack plus one for him.
Kushina will be taking a little less damage from him. As opposed to him being like an attack plus two, she'd be taking the normal damage at that point.
Yeah, and we have Tobirama built tanky as well. With a defense plus one, so this is a pretty tanky team that we have here.
Oh!
From Gaara!
Kushina was actually trying to use her tilt, I think.
Yeah, I think so. Didn't hurt that bad, though. Kushina charging up two full Water Dragon Jutsu. Going to connect.
And Kushina is basically doing what Gaara likes to do, hanging back and just ulting.
Pretty much. Except hers is not as good as his.
No.
Nice little combo into the air there.
Yeah, that was good.
And Kushina tried to throw the lightning kunai. Ultimate from Lee, sub. Countered. Kushina gets up. Just kind of
walks
up.
Over.
And ultimate from Gaara. Tobirama coming back in, clashing with Gaara. And frying pan attack. Nope, didn't hide by the counter.
Rowan's maybe looking to ult, fed against it. Gaara is actually staying out a little bit more so now.
Yeah.
Which is surprising. He didn't do that last match. So.
And sub log is active. And it's out. Ultimate, not going to connect. But he has the chance to combo now.
Yeah, he's got no subs.
Yep. And the team ultimate will connect.
Wow. Yeah, that was pretty good.
Yeah.
Attacking when they had no subs and going right off of that with the team ultimate. Still not taking as much damage, but still pretty good.
Yeah, not as much. Team Ultimate! This one will not connect. It looked like it was going to for a moment.
Almost, yeah.
Another Team Ult. This one should connect. Yep.
Yep.
And explosive bite of the Water Dragon.
Gonna make some soggy sand here.
Yep. And that
pretty
brings it to
too.
Even.
Yeah.
Too much.
Both sides are taking handicaps. Both have ointments though. Frying pan attack support connects.
Gotta love frying pan attack. Another ultimate subbed.
Wow. He just jumped and kind of just got out of it.
Yeah. And Lee coming back in here.
Yeah, that's good. They have no subs.
Oh! Wow, that little combo into ultimate.
Yeah.
Not at all.
Again, they did it twice. Jeez. If they get caught out with any like attacks here, they're gonna take some damage here, although Kushina did knock them out of that combination.
Yeah, very true. Kushina's getting her distance now, gets her chakra.
Wonder if she's gonna awaken. Her awakening can be pretty nasty sometimes. Water Dragon connects from the side, blind side, dragon.
And a frying pan attack will not come through.
Yeah, both sides have a sub here and there. No subs on Jin right now, though. If they get caught in an attack, they're pretty
water
much...
Water Dragon.
Oh, he dodges the Water Dragon.
Air combo. And another
dodges
one.
Another one. Wow.
Sub log. And Gaara. Trying to change him on Tobirama.
Now he's backing off a little bit, which is good for Gaara, just because he doesn't want to give Tobirama that distance.
Yeah. And
Team
Ult will connect. Wow.
Yeah, this team proving very strong, but again, it's Lee. Lee is definitely one of the, pretty much the heavy hitters of God.
Oh, yeah.
So it's to be expected that he's a pretty solid member in this. So, but it's good to see PTS Gaara put in some work too.
For sure, yeah. But yeah, so Team Guy will move into the next round with two handicaps out of their favor.
All right, on to round four. We have Lee and Gaara once again taking two handicaps against them against against Kushina and Fu.
Yeah, this ult's gonna get tanked, though. So
not much damage, considering she has defense pretty much 4. Oh!
Oh, denied by the fan slash. Another ultimate from Kushina.
She just wants to just throw her rage out for everyone.
Yeah, apparently. They are moving in for some combos.
Not subbing, though. I'm surprised. They have full subs. They're just tanking it.
There they go.
Oh, Dara subs and takes the other piece of fan slash.
And Kushina moving in for some combos of her own. Sand shower gets subbed. And a frying pan attack will connect.
Decent damage.
Yeah, and Kushina moving in now to do some more combos. Back to Fu. Her combo. Until
the trap. I don't think it actually hit.
It made him waste a sub. Wow.
Wow, this like Fu just keeps on shooting inwards. Like, what is she, a kunai?
I don't know. I don't know how they're doing that. I can't even do that as a player. Like, I don't understand. The AI has been doing that a lot.
Was it she was just like the right distance away to where it counted like?
Yes.
That was weird.
Because that's what happens when you swap in mid combo, but Fu wasn't coming out.
No, so, she was just kind of jumping in, like just dashing in and then getting back out again.
It's weird. It's not the first time I've seen it though. Oh, team ult. Nope, not going to connect, but it wastes the subs that Guy had. And one comes back now, but they use it right away. And a frying pan attack comes in and oh my god. He's gonna combo some into Gaara. And Fu's getting
Fu actually dashes back instead of dashing forward.
Yeah. Frying pan attack.
Those subs on their side, so I mean, if you do something about it, but they got full subs and they're not subbing.
Yeah, there's one. Oh, an ointment.
Now they're just kind of hanging back a little bit, letting them build their subs back up. Let's see.
Yep. A grab. Ultimate from Gaara. Yeah,
there you go, Gaara. Glad to see you haven't changed.
You got it. Another ultimate. This one could connect. Nope. Fan slash.
She decides just to tilt, just to. Okay, I'll just set up.
And a grab, yeah, and another ointment.
Guy steals both of their ointments.
Yeah, Kushina getting out of there.
Yeah, rightfully so. She has no subs.
Yeah. Combo attack will not connect.
Starting to get her subs back now, though. And again, Guy is. Oh, she dodges it. Wow.
Yeah.
She's playing very passive, actually, right now. Just staying back, stopping Lee from ulting there.
An interesting style from her.
Yeah, she's a little passive, a little unusual for her.
I mean, she is tanky this week, but oh, interesting. And more combos, no subs, and the green bar is still there, barely hanging on to that. The tilt comes in to interrupt the air combo, and Kushina is gonna chain, yeah. And a sleep tag.
From the sleep, is he gonna do something?
And a single
she just like, I gotta get full chakra first. Hold on.
Oh my god.
And Fu.
Sleep tags can still be useful because even though one hit catches you out, they are stunned for way longer than a lightning kudai.
She had enough time to charge from no chakra to full chakra, walk forward, and just punch.
Oh my god. So, Jinchuuriki will move into the next round with no caps. Even round 5. Alright, and on to our final round here, we have PTS Neji and PTS Gaara versus Kushina and Fu. No caps on either side. Already a lot of action.
Yeah, the way a round 5 should be. Good. Yeah. It's nice to see because you get kind of tired of seeing these sweeps all the time.
I know. Oh, we have like 2? Yeah, we had 2.
Oh,
almost.
Kushina is trying to.
Yeah, and already Team Guy used an ointment.
Maybe not the best, actually.
Yeah.
Because they probably didn't get the most out of it. Like, he's kind of doing what Tenten did for Kakushima.
Yeah,
just take them
true. All. And Kushina going for that tilt, but didn't actually trigger the.
You know, it's like, oh wow, the sand, that's good. Yeah, her traps are not like soccer.
Yeah, or Sakon Ugon's.
Yeah, it feels like hers don't hit very often. They're just kind of like, she does it just for zoning. And yeah, sometimes kind of messes with their opponent's AI, and they kind of maybe back off or something like that. They kind of do things to hope.
It's a good... Oh, gonna hit that ult. It's a good tilt. Like, I would like to keep it on her.
Yeah,
just because it does come in handy.
Yeah, I don't think it affects her very much at all. She uses it not all the time. Not as much as Naruto uses his tilt.
Yeah.
But she uses it, you know, good enough.
Yeah. And yeah, so pretty even so far. Neji's out. Kushina charging up. And Neji tried to. There's Gaara charging up. Fanslash is gonna nail him.
He's just watching. He's like, no, just a little more. A little more chakra.
And shower.
It's worth it.
Wow,
frying pan. Can't even get up for a moment.
No. Ultimate from PTF Neji. Nope. Not gonna connect.
Oh.
Team ultimate. This could connect. No.
Wow, she actually dodged that. Wow, surprisingly.
Yeah. Some nice combos here.
Hanging the combo.
Full combo. Fan slash. Will connect. Team ult. No.
Just about the right time.
Yeah. Flashing their right pan attack.
You know, those two actually. There hasn't really been many ults from Boo.
No, not many.
Which is a bit unusual for her. A lot of this damage is just coming from melee and jutsu.
Interesting. Oh, there's an ointment from Kushina.
Use her other pill to make her white.
What the hell is this whitewashing?
Wow, she's just used a bunch of those subs just to avoid rotation.
Yeah. God, it is the most deadly thing ever.
I mean, yeah, rotation is over, I guess, huh?
Yeah, pretty much. And a grab from Gaara. Ultimate? No.
Prime gets knocked out of it, though. And again, wow, she's like, he auto-attacked her out of her combo.
Yeah. Sheena trying to come in for combos of her own. And getting out of the sand shower is going to make her sub, though. Oh, and a grab!
Do some good damage there.
Yeah. Getting out of the green bar. Ultimate!
Oh, just out of range.
And Fu getting her distance. Charge up. And both charge again, but there's Neji.
They're just really like they're sizing each other up and just backing off.
Pretty much. And Neji trying to come in, ultimate!
Oh, wow.
Using some subs on that rotation there. And Neji gets an air combo off. Counter.
Oh,
gonna go right
rotation,
into that rotation.
Counter.
Yep. Both fighters getting distance.
Ooh,
coming
back
in. Fan slash.
Gaara
comes right back in. And into PTS Neji. Nope, that ultimate will not connect. She tried to grab.
There's so much going on right now here.
Yeah, there's
a
lot. And Neji trying to take this into the air. Ultimate will connect.
Oh, it might end it actually.
It probably will. Yep.
Yeah.
There it is. All right. So, Team Guy will actually take this victory, and I think PTS Gaara was very helpful in that.
Yeah, they were doing really good. Lots of blocking, dodging, good aggression. That was what they needed. And they were able to get a win.
So that will bring Team Guy up to 6-9, another 69 team. And Team Jinchuuriki will fall to 10-5. Thanks for scouting PTS Gaara for us. Very helpful. Very helpful. Thank you. Thank you.
You're so nice, Team Guy.
Giving us some great ideas. Thank you. All right, and on to our final match of the main season. We have the Akatsuki at Hidden Sand. Should be an interesting match, as we discussed before. The Akatsuki, if they win, it's going to be kind of difficult to sort out who goes where. But Hidden Sand is out of playoffs already, so...
This is just going to be just data for them now at this point.
Yeah, and they have done some interesting things with Tamari specifically that I'll get into. But yeah, I think we should just start this match. Round number one, we have Rasa with Tamari and Gaara versus Nagato, Konan, and Toki. She's got a dance, not going to connect. Ultimate from Nagato, ultimate from Rasa. Oh. Nope.
See, Rasa wanted to get on the wild ride with Nagato, so he actually got on his floating pile of sand.
Yeah. Rasa's stinky.
But yeah, so we actually have on sand Rasa with Tamari and Gaara, which usually sand does not use Tamari, if at all, ever as a starting member of their team. They usually save her as a pocket character, someone they keep at the end.
Pocket wind,
yeah. the kind you can't smell, but you know it's there.
Oh,
you know?
God. It's that, stinky as shit.
Pocket wind.
And yeah. Nagato.
Did Akatsuki use any Rio on this? Did they have any expense?
Yes. They had 6,000. They purchased an attack plus one on Konan and Naruto's chakra sharing technique for Takuzu. Oh, okay. Tamari has Toxic Bomb. That's an interesting thing that we're doing this week. Which we've been saying for, like, I don't know, this entire season.
She's had the same build pretty much the whole season.
Yeah. They gave her... What did they give her instead? Instead of Ultimate Dash, I believe? Or recently she's had Air Step and Naruto's Chakra Sharing, but... It's either that or Ultimate Dash. Instead they gave her Toxic Bomb, so she's got Defense plus 2, Berserker, and Toxic Bomb.
So it seems Akatsuki is really has a good lead right now.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, like, I don't know where the damage came from, but they did a lot of it.
That ultimate is a good start.
Oh yeah, okay, the ultimate, yeah. Did Zayn have two ointments also?
Yeah.
Wow, so that was a lot of damage that they had taken.
Yeah.
And wow. Pretty much they're taking a handicap regardless.
Oh yeah. But yeah. So Konan, actually, she has a defense plus 2 with no negatives. So that should be interesting. Nagato, he's got chakra plus 1. Technically, that gives him chakra plus 2. Not really sure why he was given chakra saver. He doesn't really use the Shura attack. But
it's usually like as a support heal pretty well. But
yeah, but I usually no chakra, so I mean...
Yeah, not usually in a combo, you won't really use it.
Yeah, it just kind of struck me as strange. But yeah, oh, ultimate. Going to just suck up all of the wind.
Getting stronger, don't!
It followed tomorrow, and then
it explodes in the fire. I will say, Konan actually has been really doing well this season for them.
Oh yeah. She's been
especially
amazing.
With this new
giant panda.
AI and a panda. Brought the panda.
Nagato. he likes pandas.
Bringing like these animals to the fight.
We saw that Jack Black film, and he really became a fan. Kung Fu Panda.
Rasa does not appreciate that, so he is proceeding to crush him.
He's gonna try beam him.
His wealth of try beam gold.
And Nagato now has enough chakra for a team ult or regular ult.
Wow, and San actually took the lead.
Yeah.
Wow. Was Rasa ult plus 2?
He is ultimate plus 2. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, that's why. Really heavily, which actually he think he's had that build for a couple weeks now. He just hasn't actually hit with any ultimates.
Yeah. Wow, Toby.
Toby's chaining. Oh, team ultimate. He's
dodging. All right.
he dodged lazily to the left. They're running slowly.
Toby with the momentum changes.
He's being a good boy, Toby. He does what he has to do.
Can I go for the ult? It might connect. No, sucked. And
oh,
a grab.
Grab.
Ultimate grab. And Toby's comes back out. And there's Nagato.
Toby went to the same school that he went to for his dancing?
Probably.
He seems really graceful.
Toby using another grab, but that one did not connect. Oh, nailing him in the face.
combo always makes me think like there's more after the roll.
Yeah.
After he just kind of like flops on his back after he's done.
Ooh, air combo there from Bowser.
Wow, that's really close. Are they gonna?
Could be it. Yep.
Ow.
Just smacked him up.
To the ground.
Akatsuki will take two handicaps moving into the next round. See you then.
All right, on to round two. Temari and Gaara, brother and sister, versus Nagato, Konan, and Tobi. Known associates.
Yeah, this is the Tamara combo. Tamara Gaara. Hakuna Matata.
Okay. The wonderful phrase. Tamara Gaara. Take some sand in your face.
Oh, wow. See? That is why her ninja dash being longer is so useful.
Yeah.
Oh, well, Tobi.
What do you do? He just,
oh
like,
my God,
he's
just
like
got,
coming from the ground.
I guess since that last hit of her normal combo starts on the ground, it like still hit him. And he's coming up. And Konan comboing here. Having to block Temari. And there's poison.
Ointment.
Oh! Combo. Not bad.
Good. Yeah, when this combination has any caps out of their favor or in their favor, it's an uphill battle for the other team, because even though they have Nagato with his Shura and Konan with her Jutsu, it's still tough, as you can see. They're just not able to close the gap.
Especially now that there's a Toxic Palm in play. It really helps take on that damage. But if Akatsuki keeps switching around, then they can avoid that damage. Although Tobi has it on him right now. He's staying out. But you know, a grab. That green bar's gone.
There goes. They're really just trying to get a cap.
Yeah.
Because it's line of priority, he already has two handicaps already, so.
And minefield jutsu.
Actually,
it's
a little bit.
Gaara's on fire.
Gonna knock it back into the bomb.
Oh, that would have been funny.
Oh.
Ultimate from Konan.
Pretty good for her. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That was actually a good defensive ultimate, because it actually kind of prevented a lot of that damage that could have occurred.
Yeah, for sure. More poison there.
I don't know if does Temari usually do full combos chaining with Gaara like that? I usually think she's more of like what she's doing now, where she just does this.
I think when she's in close range, she sometimes does it, but it's not often, I feel like. Minefield Jutsu. Gonna connect.
And
Konan dodged. Wow. I wasn't expecting that. And Temari getting her distance. Tobi trying to get in here. Trying to grab. I didn't notice that Sand actually used an ointment before.
Yeah, they used one a while ago, but they probably should use another one now.
Yeah.
But no subs, this might be it.
Yeah,
it's like,
pocket wind. Alright, so we'll move into an even round three.
Yeah, next match.
Alright, round number three. We have Temari and Gaara again tomorrow versus Tobi, Kakuzu, and Konan. I feel like this team should do a little better because it has more long range. Also, no handicaps. So that's a thing too.
Yeah, even round three.
Yeah. And Tobi just dodged it all over the place. Ultimate from Temari.
Nope, he decided not to.
Not gonna taste the grumpy.
See what they're doing here? They had Kakuzu in his other outfit to kind of distract Temari.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, from like seeing all those stitched abs.
Oh yeah, sexy as shit.
And four faces.
Oh God. Kakuzu really
Ultimate
is a disgusting
Kakuzu
piece of
with
shit,
his
isn't he?
Long snake arms or whatever that is.
God, he's a fucking nightmare.
Like Dead Space arms, whatever he is.
You saw a guy like him in real life, what would you do?
Where'd you get that?
Sweet tat, man. Sweet
tat. Did you get inside your body?
Oh, fuck, that's like a... It's extreme,
man.
Kakazu kind of dodging around, but pretty even. Although Akatsuki does have a slight lead right now. And Searing Migraine sucks.
I think Kakazu into this lab is actually pretty good because his support jutsu is really good. And it comes out fast enough, and it's in twos, or actually it's fours. So it actually has a higher chance of hitting or breaking some of Tamari's
projectiles. Although they don't have any chakra on Akatsuki's side. Akatsuki Migraine going to connect, but the fire's put out.
Instantly.
Yeah.
Now they got no subs now, so they're going to have to basically just kind of wait until they get an opening, wait until they get their subs back.
Here's a Shikigami dance.
Yeah, a connected ultimate
from Tamari. Nope, canceled. Wow.
Almost about to break his guard.
Yeah, almost about to break his guard.
Guard.
And team ultimate, this could connect. Nope.
Not, wow. I think because this is such a large map too, it's a lot easier to get that distance to avoid some of these team ultimates just without using any subs. She avoids the full combo to reduce the poison that she's on top of it. There's that jutsu there. It just really just disrupted her a lot.
They do have a lot of fire in their jutsus here. But as long as they stay on the water, it's not really going to help.
Yeah, which pretty much the rest of this fight is probably going to stay on the water. The AI tends to like to get into corners and stay there.
Yeah, pretty much. It'll gradually move towards the corner. It seems
team ultimate. Conan decided to.
I mean, it's gonna hurt, but it'll give her chakra at least.
She's lucky that Grumpy only kicked her on water.
Yeah, right.
Being on land.
Minefield jutsu. Yeah. She's still on fire. Oh, let's swap that to Gaara. Shikigami dance, subs. And Conan trying to close in here. Ultimate going to hit Tamari.
Now, when they're on fire, if they tag out, it removes fire, right?
It's still there. It just typically doesn't last long enough to keep going. That's why with poison, if they're poisoned by Toxic Palm, they can swap out and still swap back in and still be poisoned.
Okay. I didn't know if the tagging out basically was one way to remove the burn effect.
Yeah. I think they can still tag it and be burned. And grab ultimate, actually. He doesn't do those very often. And Kakazu goes for the team ult.
It's
not
going to
go far enough. Yeah.
He's closer now. He's like, I'm going to try it again.
Yeah, no. Interrupted all three times, buddy. It's not gonna work out. And Toby needs to charge up. He needs to get some chakra back. But Gaara is staying out for once. That's very unusual.
Yeah, especially in this combination, that Gaara rarely ever stays out.
Yeah, there's a grab.
Toby connects with the grab finally.
And there's some chakra shuriken for Gaara.
Toby jumps on his belly and rolls. He's just like, ah, it'd be a great place for a slip and slide.
Oh, Buster Grumpy. He's blocked. Searing Migraine will connect on Tamari. As long as they can keep it in this corner, they can do some fire damage to Tamari.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, if Kotsky can win this match, they're still going to the next lineup with two handicaps out of their favor. And as I was looking right now, I don't know if
ultimate.
They're going to be able to.
No.
Nope. Blocks it.
Yeah.
Oh, like, stops, Toby. Yeah, no stops.
Yeah. The ultimate from Tamari.
Through
Kakazu.
Wow, it doesn't stop apparently when it hits something, it just keeps on going.
I guess those Grumpies, man.
They're
just unstoppable.
Heat seeking.
Alright, well, on to the next round.
On to round four.
Yes.
Tamari and Gaara, once again, they took. They took a handicap, right?
One cap, yeah.
They took one cap against Akatsuki's last lineup, Kakazu and Kona. So we'll see if they can get past this obstacle of Sans. It seems to cause many teams issues.
Oh, yeah.
And apparently,
sure.
Regardless of position in the lineup, it's still dangerous.
Yeah. For sure. Oh, that was a nice little combo. He did with the jutsu.
Yeah, good.
And poison. Card sleeping. Now, this is Akatsuki's last lineup here.
Yeah, they need to be a little more aggressive. They need to get a little more close, do something, because they're not going to win the battle of range. They can reduce some of the effects of it with some of their jutsus, but they're not going to win that overall, because for every jutsu they throw out, Tamari can just throw out many, many more just in melee or in her ranged attacks. Wow, oh, look at that kunai.
And yeah, then she,
sand tsunamis.
Nice. How could you actually do a combo a little bit? Nice.
Ain't into that. And Sand actually has all subs and they're not subbing.
Yeah. Akazu charging up his chakra now. Trying to get in here.
Gar actually coming out a little bit more.
Yeah.
For a moment.
for a moment. Just for a sec. You don't want to back up, Kakazu. You really don't. Here's a severe migraine. But he's poisoned now.
I think poison would be something that really wouldn't affect Kakazu.
Yeah, you think so. I mean, he is, you know, dead. And Konan. Gaara trying to dash into some combos. Countering an inch of combos from CIC still poison. But it just...
He dodges the ultimate.
Yeah.
No subs on Sand. Full subs on Akatsuki.
Yeah.
This is when they'd want to close in and do some damage.
Seems like they have the opportunity to do so now. Oh. Sense breaking tag. And there's another Grumpy. Konan. Swapping back to Kakazu's tortoiseshell kill. And this is just... This is not going well for Akatsuki right now.
No, they don't want to be going even with Sand right now. This is not Sand's last lineup, so they need to be a little impossible. But at least positive, on the positive side, if they do get through this lineup, they're not going to have to deal with it.
Yeah, they're not going to have to deal with tomorrow.
This is by far their strongest lineup, so I mean...
For sure. Konan trying to close in on Tamari now. But she gets out of there.
Yeah, it's weird. They seem to have the aggression when the subs are up. When the subs are gone, they kind of back off.
Very strange.
That's kind of a thing with some other AIs too, though, or some other teams too. They'll be less aggressive when the other team has no subs. It's like they're just like being good sports about it or something.
Yeah, I guess so. It seems like maybe putting Molten Bomb on Kakazu might have been better to put like Toxic Bomb on him instead, considering all the water.
Oh, especially on this map. Any map that has a lot of water, Molten Pop should be one of those things you probably would just say, situationally, this is not a good map for him.
Yeah.
This map has about as much water as Mist map does, so, and you would not want to put Molten Palm on this map.
Pretty much. Migraine. Going to connect. That fire is put out, though. Extinguish. Shikigami Dance going to follow her and actually connect a little bit, wasting that last sub. So Konan trying to close in on Tamari now. Searing Migraine knocking her away a little bit. Will she get up into the Zolt? Nope. It ends just before she gets up.
It feels like if you get up at the later part of that ultimate, you're not going to get hit by it. It feels like the box of it has dissipated at that point.
Yeah, pretty much. Konan dodging these wind blasts. Having to block them now. Sand Tsunami does connect. Three Migraine going to get subbed from Tamari.
Sand has one ointment, Kosuke has two ointments. To avoid any two handicaps, if they take this, they definitely want to use those ointments.
Yeah, for sure. Tamari.
No subs on Sand.
Yeah.
Akatsuki going in. Are they going to chain the combo? No, just a full combo. He got the full combo on her and actually got her burning on land, which actually. He just stood there.
Yeah. Kind of did just stand there.
Like, I don't know what the fuss is about.
And Gaara trying to close in off Shikigami Dance, going to connect. Practice is charging up his chakra, and now Gaara's no gonna close in. No subs at all.
Full combo,
yeah.
Maybe the best thing that they could have done to at least for Akatsuki's part.
Oh, an ointment! They used one. At least that lets them stay in there a little bit longer. And the other one, too. Not enough to get their cap back. But...
No, it's maybe just enough for them to either get like a ultimate off or something.
Yeah. It might be enough to let them get into winning.
Well, they wasted all of Akatsuki's subs.
Yeah.
Going on the backs. Yeah. They have wasted the last sub if they get a combo off on them now.
Oh! Oh, that was about to be really impressive. Konan just needs to hit her like one time. One time, Konan. Deary Migraine will finish from behind. Wow.
That was really close.
Yeah, and they'll bring it to round five, but now they have two caps out of their favor, and that might not turn out too well for them. So let's see how that turns out. Okay, we're on to our final round now. Gaara and Danzo with two caps in their favor versus Konan and Kakuzu again. They've really been sticking in there with this team. Let's see if Akatsuki can do anything.
Yeah, Akatsuki does have two caps out of their favor, but they could still do this just because of the huge threat of Tamari is not in this match right now. So there's a chance.
Very true.
They are taking a lot of damage though, and Danzo, being the asshole that he is.
Yeah. Quite a bit. Yeah, Konan is tanky. So I mean,
kinda offsets some of the anti-caps against him.
Yeah.
Akatsuki though, is he tanky at all?
He is actually built. Yes, he has a defense plus one.
Okay, so they're closing with this tanky team, so it's not that as bad as it could be.
No. Essentially, Konan will have, like, normal damage on her, and Kakuzu will have, like, one handicap damage on him, pretty much. Because you can think of the handicaps as basically, like, one defense point in or out of their favor.
Yeah.
Oh, there's an ointment. Akatsuki could actually do this.
Yeah, they're actually taking a pretty good lead right now.
Yeah.
This is all just through like combos and stuff. I mean, they haven't really.
See how different they play when Tamari's not here.
Yeah, it's amazing what just one of their members just has, what kind of effect it has on their game.
Yeah.
But specifically, it's again with Tamari and Gaara. She was in the first lineup, and that lineup ended up.
Whoa!
That was something.
That was something, right?
Gaara going back on land to get his strength back. He's going back into the water now. Like, he's catching his breath when he goes on land because he can't survive long on water. Oh, jeez.
Oh, he needs the sand. He's basically like sand so he gets you.
Sand Getsu.
Oh! Now, Konan will tank this. It's not that bad.
Yes, still pretty even.
She can't be subbing these, like, shuriken, though.
No. She has one sub, still, but now it's gone. Voids the grappling of Gaara.
Yeah.
Gaara used an ointment.
Yeah, there's an ointment.
Oh, chain the full combo.
Full combo, yeah.
Jeez, there goes half their bar.
Yep, they still have an ointment, though. There it is.
They used it. And Shigami dance actually blocked the sand tsunami. No subs on sand.
Yeah, Akatsuki could try to do some damage there. Shikigami dance.
Wasn't too bad. It actually kept Gaara off Kakuzu, so where Kakuzu could get the chakra.
Oh yeah. Konan backing up, no subs, gonna get hit by that wind blast. A vacuum blast barrage. Forgot the name for a second. Deary Migraine will connect an ultimate from Konan, but Gaara is gonna stay out of there. No subs for Akatsuki.
Oh, this could be it for them if they get caught in some combo or an ultimate.
Nope, Deary Migraine, but the sand tsunami will hit. And so will the Vacuum Blast Barrage, of course, because it always hits.
Such a huge spread.
For damage nerf or chakra increase cost.
Oh, and yeah,
well, that's it.
Gonzo going for asshole points here.
Yeah, asshole points. Look at him. Look at his smug ass fucking. God damn it. Why do you have to be the last face we see in the main season, you motherfucker? You fucking piece of You. I hate you. You so smug with your fucking dumbass Dwemer arm shit. What the fuck?
But let's be fair.
Bandages.
He made Konoha great again by defeating all the Jiha. Those stinky bastards.
He's a fucking stinky ass old man. Fuck him.
Yeah, he is. But anyways, this brings Sand up to 8-7. But tying Taka, but Taka has the divisional over them, so they will make it to the playoffs, as we said before.
Yeah. This is really good that Taka won.
Yeah. This also means that Akatsuki will fall down to 8-7. So a lot of really close win-loss records for the Season 5 placement. So we will see you guys not next Friday, but the Friday after with playoffs.
Yes. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you, Gomel, for filling in for Burn.
Yeah, thank you. That actually helped a lot. The headache is still there, but not as bad.
I imagine.
So. We will see you guys next time.
Take care.
See ya.
Hey everybody, I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching, and I hope you continue to enjoy Naruto League. Remember to check us out on the forums, where you can talk about the teams, the matches, lineups, pretty much anything relating to Naruto League. And of course, if there are any teams you're interested in joining, don't hesitate to go on over to the forums and sign up. Every person can be a huge help. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Take care, everyone.